morning. News bulletin for today is, viral infections can now be treated with engineered proteins. Vaccines are important for prevention, but there is a great need for antiviral medicines to treat people who have become infected. Researchers at the University of Toronto have engineered the human ubiquitin protein into a new form that paralyzes a key virus enzyme responsible for causing Middle East respiratory syndrome. The technology can be applied to a wide range of pathogens, and the researchers believe that it could become a game changer in antiviral therapeutics with implications for human health and farming industry. But before these engineered proteins can be developed into medicine, researchers must find a way to deliver them into the right part of the body. New therapy developed for atherosclerosis. Researchers at Ben Gurion University and the Sheba Medical Center in Israel have developed a new therapy to treat atherosclerosis and prevent heart failure with a new biomedical polymer that reduces arterial plaque and inflammation in the cardiovascular system. This innovative E-selectin targeting nanopolymer targets only damaged tissue and does not harm the healthy tissue. The polymer has no side effects, unlike statins, which are currently the leading medication used for treating atherosclerosis. The researchers are now seeking a pharmaceutical company to bring the polymer therapy through the next stages of drug development and ultimately to the market. Eye drops to treat age-related blindness. Scientists at the University of Birmingham in the United Kingdom have developed a revolutionary new eye drop to treat a disorder called age-related macular degeneration. Scientists have invented a method of delivering the injected drug as an eye drop instead. The drop uses a cell-penetrating peptide to deliver the drug to the relevant part of the eye within minutes. The peptide drug has the potential to have a significant impact on the treatment of macular degeneration by revolutionizing drug delivery options. Thank you.